教宗方济各在讲解福传的热情要理讲授时说道，拜访一些隐修院为我们有好处，因为在那里可以祈祷和工作。每个隐修院都有自己的规则，但那里的手总是忙碌着，忙于工作和祈祷。愿上主赐给我们新的隐修院，赐给我们男女隐修会士，以他们的转导推动教会不断向前迈进。感谢天主，2022年10月10号，由于马达拉上主及圣母之仆修女会位于桃园的蛇山圣母隐修院，整修工程进行中，台中教区媒体小组成员得以有幸前往拜访，走进围栏和修女们一起祈祷，聆听那清亮澄澈的圣歌咏唱，分享了修女的圣召旅程，并欢度美好的午餐共融时光。
My name is Sister Mary Help of Christians. My Chinese name is Kao You Yan Shou Nu. I am from the United States and I am 24 years old. I first received the grace of my vocation when I was 16, and when I was 18, with the desire to be a missionary, I entered with our order in the United States. During my first year of my formation, God seemed to change all of my plans. One day I decided I would go to the chapel and do some prayer and spiritual reading, when all of a sudden I received the grace of my contemplative vocation. It was an interior illumination where I understood that God was calling me to be a contemplative, that He wanted me to give myself to Him entirely in the silence of the cloister. For me, it was very strange because I was very ignorant as to what contemplative life was. I didn't know anything about it. And yet, I had a desire to be a contemplative. And this desire grew with each day that passed. I had a certain confidence in this calling, and this confidence took away all fears of making any kind of sacrifice that entering the monastery would require from me. I asked my superiors to enter the monastery, and a few months later, God gave me the grace to be able to enter. At the end of my formation in the monastery, I offered myself to my superiors to come here to Taiwan to enter the monastery. Very happily, I arrived here on the 24th of May, and I am currently studying Mandarin at the Furen Catholic University. I am very, very happy to be here and to be able to offer to God all of my prayers and sacrifices for the people of Taiwan so that they can come to know and love Jesus and Mary. I grew up in Maryland of the United States. I am the third oldest of 11 children in my family. My parents are very, very good. Thanks be to God, I grew up in a Catholic family for most of my life, because before my parents were Protestants. My dad, before he was Catholic and then he became Protestant, and a friend of his one day invited him to come back to Mass. My dad accepted this invitation and he went to Mass with his friend, and he said it felt like he was going home after a long time. So after this experience, he went back to my mom and told my mom, I would like to come back to the Catholic faith, go back to the Catholic Church. My mom, she's very heroic, and she said that, well, if you go back to the Catholic Church, we will all go with you, because you're the head of the family, and to keep unity in the family, we will all come with you to the Catholic Church. So with that, when I was 4, my parents went back to the Catholic Church. I was baptized in the Catholic Church, and I grew up receiving very good formation from my parents good catechism. I grew up in a very good area with lots of large families. We were homeschooled, so I was always at home with my family, with my brothers and sisters. I never really learned how to cook very well. My mom always did all the cooking. But yes, I would help around the house. I helped clean. We would all take turns washing the clothes. My mom was very organized, so she always had a chart on our refrigerator. It was all color-coded. So each of my siblings, we all had a color. And so on this chart, we had like our chores. So one would wash the dishes, one would sweep the floor, one would put the food away after the meals. And then she was very organized in this way. And this color that we had was for everything. So all of our notebooks and pencils for our classes that we had in our house, they were all that color as well. So we were all we all had our own things separated. Yes, and I always helped my mom take care of my siblings. I would stay home and watch them, or I would help my mom change my baby brother's diaper or things like that. My mom taught me many things, and sewing is one of those things. But since I entered the convent when I was 18, many things I learned in the convent. So, for example, sewing or cooking, baking a cake or things like that. Most of these things I learned being in the convent. When I was 20, I went to Italy to enter the monastery. And for me, it was a very big jump because I had never left the country like that before. I have never left my family in that way before, being so far away from them and not being able to go and see them. It was very difficult for me in the beginning. I didn't know Italian. I didn't know Spanish, which is the language of the congregation, so most of our sisters know Spanish. And so when I went to Italy, it was a very big jump for me. Yes, the language was very difficult for me to learn. Spanish and Italian, it took me a long time to learn how to speak or understand anything. So I think being in Italy helped me a lot, prepared me to come here to Taiwan. Because I was there for 4 years, and not being able to really be able to communicate myself very well. Here in Taiwan, I really want to be able to speak with the people. To be able to learn well Chinese is something I really desire. I'm not very good with languages. It has always taken me a really long time to learn them. But I really would like to be able to learn so I can speak with the people here. And also to be able to learn more about the culture, because I've always loved this culture. Even when I was little in my house, I've always loved the Chinese, Taiwanese, these kinds of cultures. Ever since I was little, I've always loved your culture. I've always loved the food. I've always loved the different designs, the Chinese characters, the Chinese traditional clothing. All of these different things, even the music, I've always had an attraction to these things. You know? And growing up, we oftentimes ate Chinese food in my house. And so from a very young age, I've always had a natural attraction for this culture. And so when I had entered the convent, I had met different missionaries who have been here and have had experienced the missions here. And they really inspired me a lot, listening to the different stories of the people that live here. And so with time, I was really praying, and I really could see that God wanted me to offer myself to come here. And I was very happy to be able to do so. It was a very big jump also, because it's on the other side of the world, you know? And the culture is very different from my own. The language is very different from my own. But I'm very happy to be here because I know God wants me to be here. And I'm happy that I can be here to pray for all of you and to hopefully one day be able to help you all spiritually with my words in Chinese.
我姓谢，我的名字是谢秀平，然后我的会名是 Maria Filia Dorcilis， 就是温顺的女儿。那我入了修会六年了。我23岁的时候入了修院，所以现在30岁了。那我自己觉得我的圣教是一个奇迹。然后因为好像我家人只有爸爸妈妈，他们开始是教友，就是外婆奶奶全部都不是。我父母结婚之前决定了灵洗。然后一年过后我生了，所以我觉得天主就是好像我们都说嘛，天主我们没生的时候天主已经想到我们了，所以我父母他们灵洗了我就生了，然后我就也觉得也接受了灵洗。然后呢我们小的时候也没有去教堂很多，到我15岁的时候才去寻找我自己是谁，到底是信什么的。因为我也去了一个基督教的学校，所以18岁的时候才决定要做一个教友，所以才做那个我们怎么讲见证嘛 confirmation， 才接受见证。也没有想过要当修女，其实讲真的我要当一个大律师，我要当一个大律师，赚很多钱，就是舒舒服服的在家啊。有一次我在祈祷的时候，有一点好像 Hollywood， 但是我真的在祈祷的时候，我就一直跟耶稣说：“耶稣啊，我真的要给你我的全部。”好像我给了你不够，但是因为我那时候还读着法律，对吗？所以我的时间也没有这么多，我也需要做家里的事，也需要读书，也需要做等等之类的事，所以我没办法全部都属于你。我是那个渴望这样去祈祷，突然间好像一个阳光，我听到天主的声音说啊，你在叫我叫你当一个秀女，我就什么我就什么很惊讶哦，我不要谈这个对话。那我就跟他说好，我们做一个约定啊，2年之后我们谈这个，因为我需要祈祷，我需要睡觉，但是我不要谈这件事啊。但是天主真的很奇迹，因为在这个时间呢我有一个很好的朋友，他很久以前已经要做一个神父了，但是在照顾他的奶奶，所以刚刚好奶奶过世了的时候，他就认识了我们的修会，也邀请了神父们修女们来我们的国家认识认识我们。在那个时候我就看到我们的修女，那我看到他们的时候我讲原来我可以跟随耶稣，但是也可以这么的快乐的生活，就是可以真的没有钱，真的就贫穷服从这样的生活，但是生活得很开心啊。那时候我就觉得还不错这个主意，但是也没想太多。后来他们也邀请了我去一个青年日，我在那边看到自己的神父跟年轻人一直跑来跑去踢球足球，看到修女们跟年轻人打篮球的时候，我在那个时候觉得 OK， 有可能这个是天主准备给我了，有可能我要这样的生活。当然那时候我的生活另外一部分就是我刚刚毕业，我 我读法律，刚刚毕业，然后在大学教书，也在做我们的，因为我们读了法律过后还有一张纸要考，所以我在准备那个。啊，那怎么办？我爸爸很渴望我做一个律师，我也很渴望，那就没办法。所以呢，我就跟我父母说的时候，我的妈妈跟爸爸都很伤心哦。我第一次看到我爸爸妈妈这么伤心啊，因为我爸爸妈妈都可以说，就是我要做什么都支持的，但是这个他们不能接受。我跟他们说的时候，他们的表情，特别是我妈，我觉得她的表情是好像我已经死了，好像失去了一个女儿。但是我就决定了，所以讲，我一定要去。我妈去探访我的时候跟我说，你是属于这里的。我妈妈自己跟我说，然后我跟我妈说，你为什么早一点不跟我说？因为我自己都不知道我属于这里啊，所以我一直要想啊，要祈祷啊，去知道是不是天主旨意。但是我妈妈跟我这样说，那我从那边以后我就很放心了，很快乐 的去当修女。但是我当修女的时候，所以我的意向是要做一个传教师，然后我很喜欢跟年轻人在一起，因为我那时候我入职时候是23岁嘛，然后所以我在4年在菲律宾，然后我就去到意大利了。有一次我们去探访我们的隐修的部分的修女，然后最后我们有一个大节日一起吃饭的时候，完了之后，院长，我们的总会长，对，总会长，他就宣布啊，有些修女，他们现在会当隐修的修女。刚刚好，这些修女都是我的朋友，而且他们也是20岁、25、30岁这样。回去的时候就回到圣堂里祈祷，因为就是有一个习惯，就是回到家会祈祷，然后才回房间。所以那天呢，我去圣堂的时候，我真的听到耶稣跟我说，他要我这样奉献我的生活。他不是一个声音，但是我真的很确定的知道他在邀请我这样奉献自己。就这样，但是那个星期每个下午都会哭，但是不知道为什么哭。那这个耶稣也没有逼我，所以我就继续我的生活，但是那个思想会一直回来，好像我在祈祷的时候，我在祈祷耶稣小的时候怎么跟圣母妈妈，我就祈祷啊，你看这样的隐修，这样的就是好像隐藏的生活有多么好。过了一阵子，平静了一阵子，我就跟耶稣说，好，耶稣啊，你到底要我这样奉献我的生活吗？如果你要的话，我就要。后来我才发现，天主是不会给我一个更清楚的，怎么说，怎么 assign 记号，因为他已经邀请了我一次，但是他不会逼我，因为天主就是这样，就是一个邀请，所以每个圣召就是一个邀请。对我来说是困难，但是天主不会逼，所以我跟他说，你要我就要，好像很为难我的时候，耶稣也不说我要，他要的是我们很甘愿的、甘心的去选择他所邀请我们的那条路。所以过后呢，我发现了这个的时候，我就跟耶稣说，好，我不需要做一个隐修修女为了得救，我也不需要做了这个为了什么什么什么，但我自己愿意，为了代表我对你的爱。从那边的时候，我才写信奉献自己 给我们的总会长。所以我觉得如果现在有一个人会问我，你为什么选择做一个隐修的修女呢？我只可以回答说，为了，怎么说呢，在英文是 To be with him who first loved me， 先爱我的那一位，为了跟他在一起。就是好像圣经说的那个玛利亚，就是坐着耶稣的脚下，你听他说话，没有别的愿望，只有那个。入了隐修隐修院，跟他们生活的时候，自己觉得好像一个鱼在那个 aquarium， 好像在那个鱼馆呢，因为觉得可以呼吸啊。但是为什么可以呼吸？因为我们在隐修院的生活就是祈祷祈祷祈祷祈祷。因为我觉得就是我们有时候也会这样觉得嘛，哈，就是也自己也是一个华人，就是我们都是会讲啊，你做了这个为了什么，会有什么的效果。所以有时候自己虽然是一个修女，也不应该有这样的想法，但是有可能也会觉得，哦，你天天都在祈祷，你干嘛？你什么都不做，起码你是一个传教的修女，你在帮助人啊，在做了什么，在学校做的等等之类。但是你在里面你做什么？你天天都在祈祷啊。哦，我自己也有一部分也问了天主，天主啊，你给了我这么多的天分 ，OK， 也不是很多，但是也有一点点。但是你叫我进了隐修院，那这个天分又怎么样？为什么要这样呢？自己也想不开，就是想不到，想不到。但是后来我们看到的就是，我们的天分都是天主给的，那天主知道怎么用是最好的。另外一部分就是说，你看我们都每次说嘛，祈祷是最重要的。我们传教的果实是从哪里来的？从我们祈祷，从我们的灵生生活，我们的不是呢 sacrifice 呢，是从牺牲，是从这些东西，我们才领到天主的恩宠，帮助了这么多灵魂。所以如果我们是相信这个的话，那祈祷不是最重要的东西吗？那祈祷不是我们唯一需要做的东西吗？
谢谢会长扎培德修女给了我们很大的空间与自由，在不打扰修女们固定的作息下，带着修女们配合着我们录影的要求，修女们始终笑逐颜开，喜乐是那么的自然流露出来，我们也感染了那份静谧的平安。隐修不是与世隔绝，而是以静默拥抱世界，全然生活于天主的临在中，以祈祷支持着我们每个人的信仰与使命。教宗说，隐修士的心就如同一个天线，这颗心每天接受世界上正在发生的事情，为之祈祷和转求。隐修士是宣讲的跳动的心，他们的祈祷是基督奥体所有成员的氧气，是支持使命的无形力量。 默观者，男女隐修会士，是为整个教会默默祈祷工作的人。这就是爱，就是在隐修院里为教会祈祷，为教会工作而表达出爱。让我们彼此代祷。